1997 V-Bus Furnace Reline. Bottom set. Big bed. They're lancing through the bottom of the hearth through the carbon block, getting ready to sap the last bit of iron out of the furnace.
Yeah.
is the sea furnace. First day of the outage, there's B furnace. B was turned over at 7 a.m. this morning to the contractors. As you can see, the cranes are up. Big thing right now is working on the top. Removing that structure. In the center of the picture is the bleeder, one of the bleeder valves. Both those will get pulled today. There's the other one. We'll remove that structure, the stairway, all the ancillary equipment. There's the charging deck. Man standing on top where the bells are. Part of the stack. Bath house floor. An engineering trailer. Four stoves. This is about 3 o'clock, Monday, 15 to 8. You can see a lot of furnace coming down already. Bleeder valves are off. Big bell hoppers out.
Large square rectangular areas.
Can't get my bearings.
The area at the bottom of the screen is what we call a scab. It's a material that's attached to the side of the furnace. Skyline, that's the Rensin right there, GM building. there's the Ambassador Bridge, that's Windsor, Canada. This is my 97 F-150.
Okay, here it is. It's about 8:30 at night. There's the skyline now on B furnace. Downcomers and one of the offtakes are down, I think. Take a look. Yep. Downcomer and one of the offtakes is off and on the ground. There's the charging deck. Looks like they're continuing to cut and remove the superstructure. Big 500 ton crane sticking in the way there. The blast furnace at night. September 10th, 6:30 in the morning. It's like, both offtakes, uptakes are off. All that's left is the top part of the superstructure. And it looks like it's getting ready to go.
Vice Presidents and Board Members, they all put their pants on like you and I. All you have to do is treat them with respect.
Yeah.
And be careful what you tell them.
Keeps going out of focus. I don't understand.
These things that look like paddles sticking out, are those to hold the refractory or the gunite? No, those are actually cooling plates. There's a copper plate.
There's a tube in there?
There's a panel. Water panels on the inside of them.
That's to cool the refractory.
You can see the rivets on the structure. That means that shell. That's because that was built in 1917. Take some downcomers, crossover, new stop. Really don't help it. Okay, here we are, top the skips up. Only the sergeant back right. There's the rest of the skip. And there is copper. The objects along the bottom are copper coolers that are used to chill the refractory inside the furnace and keep the furnace shell. You can see where they were just melted off. Here's inside the new bustle pipe where the hot air is blown into the bottom of the furnace. There's insulating brick. These are cracks in the main part of the shell furnace. Major problems, we had to clean them up and re-weld them. You can see holes in the furnace where bad parts of the furnace shell had been replaced or removed. When you shut a furnace down, there's a big puddle of steel that solidifies in the bottom of the furnace. That's called a salamander, and you have to remove it somehow from the furnace. One way is to use dynamite to blow it into smaller pieces so that it's easily removed.
There's one of the big chunks. See part of the bottom fat, pipe off of it.
Ha ha ha!
We used dynamite to clean out the gas washer also.
Dylan's getting ready to go.
Speed this up so that it doesn't take as long. This thing is moving very slowly. You can see where we removed the top of the old furnace and built the new top of the furnace, and then we'll put it in place and we'll weld the new top back onto the furnace.
Thank you.
down the railway.
The new superstructure is in place. The object on the right, the pipe, is what we call a pant leg. This is the hearth area of the furnace. As you can see, there's lots of new piping, and the bottom of those coolers, I'll zoom in on it right here, but there's a lot of erosion just from years and years and years of cooling water impacting on that surface of the steel. We had to repair all those also. Here's new copper coolers that will keep the new refractory cool.
The hydraulic power unit room. Third floor, hoist house. Thank you.
These lifting beams are how the large bell and small bell are operated when the furnace is running. These are called anchors, and what we'll do is go in and spray refractory inside there, and that those clips are used to anchor or hold the refractory to that steel pipe. The river at the back is the Rouge River. There's the slip where we bring our raw materials in. That's a field of iron ore, which is used to make the steel. There's a couple ore bridges you saw in the picture. That's the Ford Rouge Complex, where they built Mustang for several years. And that's the caster in that area.
Yeah.
This is a violet blue flame. It's from the blast furnace gas. It's very beautiful at night. Brick lining inside the furnace, all brand new refractory. It's got over a million bricks in it at this point. Thank you. This is called a rotary distributor. It takes the raw material, the ore and coke, and evenly distributes it inside the furnace.
Thank you.
liquid iron usually comes out of the furnace at about 2900 degrees Fahrenheit. This is the finished furnace. I'm the furthest person on the right. This is the cast house floor just before we started up. This is the engineering team. On the left, you have Scott Reed, a very good friend of mine, fine gentleman. Next, you have me, David Johnson. The third guy in the back is a contractor. I can't remember his name. The guy in the middle is another contractor. His name is Glenn Farrell. Then we have John Kaffenberger and Dave Morris. He's my boss in the green shirt. The guy on the right is Steve Quo, another Rouge Steel engineer.